以下是耶稣针对奇迹正文第七章天国的礼物第十节苦乐不分所做的事宜，请在看完奇迹正文第七章第十节之后再来聆听。 You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus. 你确实是有福之人，我是你所知的耶稣。 Mostly,What brings people to studying a course in miracles is suffering, and that suffering has come from the decisions that they have made using the ego. 人们来学习奇迹课程的原因大多是由于痛苦，而一个人所经历的痛苦是源于他用小我来做决定。And there comes a point in everybody's life on this earth plan where the person realizes that what they are doing is not making them happy and what they are doing, even though it is using their free will, they are not choosing things that benefit them in the long run. 这个地球上的每个人都会来到生命中的一个时间，此时他们会发现自己所做的事情并没有带给自己快乐，虽然他们是使用自己的自由意志去做那些事情，但是他们并没有选择对他们长远来说有益的事情。 They do not make them truly joyfulIn the long run, 那些事情到最后并没有带给他们真正的喜悦。 So when you are at a stage in your life where you are unhappy and you look around and you see that perhaps your health is not what you would like, your finances are not what you would like, your relationships have been broken, you've got some difficulties in your family. You've got confusion at what you should be doing with your life. What we want you to understand is that you got yourself into the place by listening to the ego's dictates.
因此当你处在令你感到不快乐的人生阶段时，比如说你环顾四周而发现你的健康状况并不理想，你的财务状况并不理想，你的人际关系破裂，你的家庭面临困难，你对自己这一生该做什么感到困惑，我们希望你知道你之所以处在这样的境地是因为你听从了小我的指令。
So, the ego's dictates are not consistent. They will be all over the place. Some of the ego's dictates will be in direct contravention to each other. And so you will get mixed results and mixed emotions. You will get ups and downs.You won't have any equanimity, you won't have any balance, you won't be able to make long-term strategies for your life.
须知小我的指令会前后不一，它是乱无章法的，甚至它的某些指令是自相抵触的，因此你会得到混杂的结果及混杂的情绪。你会情绪起伏不定，你无法得到平静，也无法达到平衡，你没有能力为你的人生拟定长远的策略。
When you begin to listen to inner guidance, which is coming from source energy, then you are beginning to do the will of God. Our dear one had a perfect example in her darling dog, Dolphy. Tina's ego, Tina did not want to get a dog. She did not want the responsibility. Responsibility was a big issue for her.
当你开始聆听来自源头能量的内在指引时，你会开始行使上主的旨意。一个很好的实例就是我们的传讯人 Tina 与她的爱犬 Dolphy。其实 Tina 的小我并不想要养狗，他不想承担责任， 责任对他来说是一个很大的问题。
She did not want the long-term commitment. Commitments were a big thing for her. She did not want to have a creature so close and demanding love all the time, looking at her all the time. She had many, many issues. We'll call them within her own mind.That prevented her from getting a dog.
她不想做出长远的承诺，承诺对她来说是一个很大的问题。她不想要身边有只动物整天需要爱，整天盯着她。她的内心有着许许多多我们所谓的问题，这些问题使她不想要养狗。
But she kept getting this feeling to get a dog.Even though it went against her ego's will. So there was some conflict initially, but after a couple of comments from other intuitive beings, I see a dog around you. There's a dog in your future. One day, she decided that her life did not look the way she wanted it to look.
但是她又一直有着这种感觉，养一条狗，即使这样做违反她小我的意愿，所以刚开始她的内心有一些冲突，但之后有两位能够通灵的人告诉她，我看到你身边有一只狗，你的未来有一只狗。有一天他觉得自己人生并不如他想要看到的样貌。
In fact, she was quite lonely, and so she decided that she would get a dog. She would listen to that guidance, and she would get a dog.
事实上他感到非常孤单，所以他决定要养一只狗。他将听从内在的指引去养一只狗。
And so the first few weeks of getting this dog were very, very stressful for our dear one. For weeks, she contemplated selling the puppy, big puppy making her get up at all hours of the day and night, out in the rain and the dark, pooping on things. It was just a stressful time for our dear one.
开始养这只狗的前几周 ，Tina 感到压力很大。大约四周之后，她思索着卖掉这只幼犬。这只大型的幼犬使她早晚得经常起身，在雨天及黑暗中出去散步，且她还到处拉屎。对她来说，这是备受压力的时期。
But the reason she got the dog was that she didn't like the way her life looked, and she knew this, and she knew that the guidance was coming from spirit. It was not coming from her. That the first 6 or 8 weeks, the ego had to be subdued.
然而，他养狗的理由是他不喜欢自己人生的样貌。他知道这一点，且他也知道养狗的这个指引是来自于圣灵，而非出自于他。因此，起初的6到8周，他必须克制小我。
And she came very, very close to selling her dog. But what that dog began to teach her was affection.And love and companionship and getting outside and regularly exercising and putting the computer down.
然而这只狗开始教导它的是情感、爱与陪伴，还有到户外去经常的运动，关掉电脑。
And over those reconditioning weeks, when the dog was teaching our dear one to be healthier, to be happier, to be more loving, to be more connected. It was very, very difficult for our dear one's ego.
在这几周重新调整的期间，当这只狗在教导蒂娜活得更健康、更快乐、更有爱心、更加连结时，对蒂娜的小我来说是非常困难的。
And in the end, the ego was retrained for the pleasures and the wonderful, wonderful elements and aspects of dog ownership.Became very, very clear and present in our dear one's experience, and she began to really enjoy it.
到最后，小我接受了重新的训练，能够享受养狗的喜悦、美好及美妙的经验。因此，缇娜想要拥有那只狗的想法也越来越明确，她开始真正享受这个经验。
This is the perfect example of what the ego can try and convince you to do. Have another piece of cake, not go for a swim. It's too much work. All of these sort of things that the ego counsels you to do or not to do to restrict yourself.Not to communicate, not to be loving, not to be open, not to go out in nature because it's too messy, it's too wet, it's too hot, it's too cold, it's too windy, it's too dusty. All of those excuses that you all use.
这是一个完美的实例，说明小我可能尝试说服你去做的事，比如再吃一片蛋糕，不要去游泳，这太费事了，诸如此类。小我劝你去做或不要去做的事，都是在限制你，使你不要去交流，不要活得有爱心，不要敞开自己，不要出去接近大自然，因为太脏乱了。太潮湿了，太热了，太冷了，风太大了，灰尘太多了等，种种你们都会使用的借口。
And yet, here was a great gift from Spirit. This beautiful, beautiful creature that has transformed our dear one's experience more profoundly.Than she could ever have known. She's very grateful that she knew enough not to listen to her ego, even though it got very loud and very persistent in those early weeks of having this dog.
然而，这是圣灵圣来的一份大礼。这只美丽的动物已经转化了缇娜的经验，比她过去所能想象的更加深入。她非常感激的是，她深知不能听从自己的小我，即使刚开始那几周，小我的声音非常洪亮且非常坚持。
We give you this example so that you can see how spirit works.You can see how the Holy Spirit works with you to bring you experiences that you need to have to expand your consciousness and to disempower the ego mind.
我们举这个例子，好让你明白圣灵是如何运作的。你能够看出圣灵是如何与你合作，来带给你你所需要的经验，以扩展你的意识并削弱小我之心。
All of you have got where you are because you've done what you've wanted to do.
你们大家之所以处在目前的境地，乃是因为你们做了你们想做的事情。
Now, some of you will say, No, no.My husband wanted to do this, or my teacher wants to do that, or my boss fired me. But the truth of the matter is, you are where you are because of the last 1,000 decisions that you made.
但可能有人会说，不，是我丈夫要这样做的，或者是我老师要这样做的，或者是我的老板
把我解雇的。事实上，你处在目前的状态是由于你之前做出的上千个选择。
And we want you to understand that. You can begin to listen to the source guidance. You can begin to feel into things that want to happen, even though they may go against your ego, even though they may go against everything you have been taught.
我们希望你了解的是，你可以开始聆听源头的指引，你可以感觉一下你希望发生的事情，可能违背你的小我，可能违背你过去被教导的所有观念。
You have to remember as a Course in Miracles student that this teaching inverts the world that you are living in, and your world is an inverted world.Where good is bad and bad is good. Where healthy is unhealthy and unhealthy is healthy. Where fear is promoted as a good thing and love is condemned.
身为奇迹学员，你必须谨记这部课程的教诲，倒转了你所生活的世界，因为你所生活的世界是颠倒的，当中好的就是坏的，坏的就是好的。健康的就是不健康的，而不健康的却是健康的。恐惧受到推广变成是一件好事，而爱却受到谴责。
We want you to understand this and know that you will have guidance if you step back from doing the ego's dictates. You will feel the ego's dictates by their limited nature, by their negativevibration, by their fear, by their restriction, by the ideas putting out inspiration that you have like a wet blanket.
我们希望你了解这一点，并且知道，只要你不听从小我的指示，你就会获得指引。你会知道那是小我的指引，它会带给你一种限制的感觉，它是负面的振动频率，使你感到恐惧和约束，而且会泼你冷水。
Your vital life force and your connection to the Holy Spirit is where you will find your salvation, and we encourage you to keep doing this work.
须知你的生命力以及你与圣灵的连接才是你的救恩所在，所以我们鼓励你持续学习这部课程。
I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again.
我是你所知的耶稣，我们下次再会。